The report came out that Michael Porter Jr. is dealing with a foot drop and is gonna have to wear a brace on his ankle at the upcoming NBA Summer League. In this video, I'm gonna help explain to you what a foot drop is, what it can be caused from, and what it all could mean in the context of Michael Porter Jr.'s career going forward. If you like this type of content and want to stay up to date with future videos, make sure you hit that subscribe button and let's get started. It's being reported as a symptom of his previous back surgery, so let's start off there with taking a look at what might have happened. To quickly recap, he had two previous back surgeries before he's even played in the NBA. Both of them were what we call microdiscectomies, which in short is a procedure where they go in and try to remove a piece of the disc that's pinching on or herniating on the nerves leaving the spinal cord. And we hadn't really heard much about his recovery until this recent news. A foot drop is exactly what it sounds like. It's when, for a variety of different reasons, the muscles that help pick your foot up off the ground or dorsiflex your foot are too weak to work, and so your toes can get caught and you have a dropped foot. The primary muscle in the foot that controls this action is the tibialis anterior, and it's innervated by a nerve called the deep peroneal nerve. To understand what's causing a foot drop, we have to take a look first at the muscle and then trace everything backwards to try to figure out where the defect is and what's controlling it. If we start at the anterior tibialis muscle and then go to the main nerve is the deep peroneal nerve. That comes off of a branch called the common peroneal nerve, which actually wraps around the outside of the knee. Common peroneal is a branch of the sciatic nerve, which then originates up in the lumbar and the sacral levels of the spinal cord. So if anything on this pathway isn't working, you're gonna have a foot drop. Either the muscle can be damaged or any of these individual nerves or the actual roots at the spinal cord themselves can be pinched or damaged, causing that weakness in the muscle. One particular example in the case of Cowboys' Jalen Smith, he had a knee injury, and the common and the deep peroneal nerve run right by the knee, and so if you've dislocated, sprained any of the ligaments in your knee, you can have damage to that nerve as well. But in the case of someone like Michael Porter Jr. who's had back surgery, this probably needs to be traced back to the area near the spine. If any of the nerves leaving the spinal cord are getting pinched, they can cause the nerve to be impaired and not fire the muscle down below. In the case of a foot drop, the two most common nerve levels we think of are L4 and L5, in particular L5, or the fifth lumbar nerve root. If someone has a herniated disc in their back that's pushing on that nerve root, that can lead to a foot drop. A key part that we don't know about in the case of Michael Porter Jr. is when exactly this foot drop developed. It's being reported that this was a symptom of his back surgery, and so we can assume that it had something to do with those events. Like I said earlier though, sometimes a foot drop can actually be one of the symptoms that cause someone to have these surgeries. If the foot drop developed after the surgery, then that would be considered a bad outcome. That's not an expected thing to happen after one of these surgeries. So it's really crucial to try to understand whether or not this foot drop was present before his surgeries, or if it was something that he woke up with, or if it's been something that's progressed since his surgery. It's been quite some time since his last surgery, and there's been a lot of video clips where we can actually see him playing, and it doesn't look like he's using any sort of a brace. Now, it's possible that he just doesn't need the brace when he's shooting around in the gym, but I would think that if a player is trying to rehab and get back and get used to using the brace, they'd be wearing it all the time. So it's a little unclear when exactly this foot drop might have developed, but it's important to understand because if this is a new thing that's developed since his surgery, then I'm sure they've done a lot of tests and workup to try to figure out what might be causing it, whether there's new nerve damage, something new or different going on in the spine, causing that muscle to be weak. The good part is though, this doesn't have to be a permanent thing. If the nerve has just been stretched or pinched, these nerves can recover, and we saw this be the case with Jalen Smith. He had to wear a specific type of brace for a period of time, but now doesn't have to wear the brace anymore and he has that strength back in his foot. The key is getting the diagnosis correct though, so that you can treat it appropriately and make sure that there's no ongoing damage. The specific type of brace that he's going to be wearing is something called an AFO, or an ankle-foot orthosis. What these are trying to do is provide support to keep the foot from dropping down. So there's a piece that wraps around the calf or around the side of the leg, and then a plate that goes underneath the foot to provide stability and keep that foot from dropping or slumping down. The particular brace that Jalen Smith wore was one called a Ritchie Dynamic AFO that is a little bit more lightweight, a little bit more friendly for playing in high-level sports, and it actually allows a little bit more freedom of movement in the foot so that you're not completely restricting the player's motion. This is probably gonna feel similar to playing in an ankle brace like you might wear if you're prone to sprained ankles, But instead of preventing a lot of that side-to-side movement, like rolling your ankle, it's going to prevent that foot from pushing down very much. They do allow you to bend the ankle up so that if you need to push off and move, you can do that. But there will definitely be a period of trying to get used to how this works and how this feels for him as he's playing in summer league. So the long-term prognosis depends entirely on what exactly is causing the foot drop. If it's something new from the spine, if it's something from one of the nerves that has left the spine, or if it's just a symptom of the muscle being weak. Nerves can heal and nerves can recover, and so as long as you're able to treat the underlying cause, this is something that can recover where we wouldn't suspect he'd have to wear a brace for a long-term period. But keep a close eye on him during summer league, see how he's playing, see how he's moving. Certainly wearing a clunky brace on your ankle and foot is gonna affect your mobility, and so it'll be important to see how he does with this. Thanks as always though for watching everybody. I hope you all learned something and enjoyed this video. Let me know questions, comments you have below. And until next time, thanks for watching and we'll see you later.